Hello everyone and welcome to the channel. Zach D Productions here, and I'm here for a list video for you guys. Now for this list, I'll be going over 10 rumored 2022 album releases that either I have speculated or other people have speculated that are going to happen, and albums that are going to release in 2022 by really great bands. Now keep in mind, this is not necessarily my list of the most anticipated albums of 2022. I'll save that for a later date. These are just rumored album 2022 releases. There's no guarantee that all these albums will be released in 2022. I mean, obviously, if that does happen, I mean, we're in for a great year for music for sure. And I'm sure that at least a few of these will happen in 2022. A few of these bands will release albums in 2022. I definitely see how that can be likely, of course. So let's go ahead and get started with this list. This list is in no particular order, by the way. So the first band I want to talk about is Breaking Benjamin. I think this is the first band that comes to mind when a lot of people think of rumored 2022 album releases when it comes to rock and metal. I just personally don't see why Breaking Benjamin wouldn't release a new album in 2022, since, well, we're definitely due for a new Breaking Benjamin album, let's be honest here. Ember came out in 2018, and we all know about their acoustic album Aurora, which, I'll be honest, doesn't really hold up that well for me. As for Ember, the album holds up a little bit better than Aurora, but not by much. So whatever Breaking Benjamin has to offer next, I hope it'll be their best work in a long time. Maybe their best thing since, you know, the pre-hiatus days or whatever. But either way, I think a lot of people are expecting a new Breaking Benjamin album in 2022, and for good reason. Again, I just don't see why this band wouldn't release one in 2022. Because if not, well, why did this band even come back from hiatus to begin with? You know, it kind of makes you wonder, you know? Because it's not like we receive albums from this band all that often anyways. But either way, Breaking Benjamin's a solid band. You could argue they've never released a bad album. I don't think they've ever released a bad album, personally. Now, obviously, there's albums better than others, of course. Like, I think We Are Not Alone is probably their weakest album. If not that album, then at least Ember, but I don't know. Even those albums have some solid tracks from them, so yeah, Breaking Benjamin, definitely a solid band, and I'm definitely looking forward to their next album. So the next band I want to talk about is Killswitch Engage. I think this is another one that some people are expecting. I've noticed not a lot of people are rumoring or speculating the possibility of a new Killswitch Engage album in 2022. Do I think it's possible? Absolutely, because Killswitch Engage, they're one of those bands that do like to release an album like once every few years or so, like once every 3 years. At least that's the way it's been with the last few albums from the band, at least since Jesse's return to Killswitch Engage. So I would not be the least bit surprised if we got a new Killswitch Engage album in 2022. Now, yeah, Killswitch Engage, when they release new music, they're kind of one of those bands that you kind of already know what to expect when you listen to a new Killswitch Engage album. They are a pretty consistent band in metalcore, which some people might see as a good thing, and that is a good thing, you know? I think what they do very well, so I can't really complain about it, and I would still definitely look forward to a new Killswitch Engage album if one is coming out in 2022. So this is one that I definitely wanted to mention here. So the next band I want to talk about is Metallica. This is another one of the biggest rumored 2022 album releases, and I can definitely see why. Would I be surprised if we got a new Metallica album in 2022? Maybe, maybe not. I'm not really sure what to expect, to be honest. Now, sure, whatever they come out with, it's not going to be as good as their classic era, the 80s, early 90s time. But that doesn't mean that this band is not capable of creating good music. Even their last album, Hardwired to Self-Destruct, I thought was pretty solid for the most part. I mean, the closing track to that album, Spit Out the Bone, I thought was one of the best songs that they've done in a good number of years. Probably the best song that they've done since the Black Album era, probably. definitely a solid track, and that does prove that Metallica can still make really great songs. So, yeah, even though maybe Metallica's new album will not be as good as their classic era, that doesn't mean that the album won't be good at all, you know? I still think that they're capable of making a really good album. And it does seem like ever since the 2000s, they started getting better with each album, you know? Death Magnetic was an improvement from Saint Anger, Hardwired was an improvement from Death Magnetic, so I hope they keep that trend going with this next album. I mean, maybe the next Metallica album will be the best thing since their classic era. We'll have to see. I mean, I don't know. I guess there's a chance we could get a new Metallica album in 2022, but only time will tell, of course. I'm not really sure what to expect with this one. So the next band I want to talk about is Overkill. Overkill's another band that likes to release an album like once every few years or so I would definitely not be surprised if we got a new Overkill album in 2022. And this is a very consistent band in thrash metal. You can argue that they've never released a bad album either. That is, of course, debatable, but, you know, I'm sure whatever they have to offer next is going to be really solid, because I really do like the modern era of Overkill. The last album, The Wings of War, I thought was a solid album, and it was one of my favorite albums of the year it came out, which I believe was 2019. So I would not be surprised if we got a new Overkill album in 2022. So yeah, this is a band that I definitely wanted to mention here. So the next band I want to talk about is Judas Priest. This is another band that's been working on a new album for quite some time now, so I would not be surprised if we got a new album from them in 2022, and if so, that would be exciting, and it would easily be one of my most anticipated albums of 2022. This is one that I would no doubt pre-order and things like that. Definitely a solid band, really great band, and one of the most essential metal bands, I would say. Definitely a must-listen band if you claim to love metal. I mean, you gotta check out Judas Priest one way or another, but either way, we know about Judas Priest and the new album that they have in the works, and, you know, their last album, Firepower, was a solid album, and that album especially has me excited for what this band is going to do next, because Firepower is a fantastic album, I think. It was one of my favorite albums, probably even my favorite album of the year it came out, which was 2018. So yeah, I mean, there's a chance that if Judas Priest comes out with an album in 2022, it could be album of the year contender. I mean, we'll have to see. I mean, we really will. I mean, I'm sure whatever they have to offer next is going to be really strong. So the next band I want to talk about is Death Angel, another consistent band in thrash metal, and this is another band that likes to release a new album every few years or so, at least as of late. So I'm sure we'll get a new Death Angel soon, whether that be next year or 2023 at the latest. But I would not be surprised if we got a new Death Angel album in 2022. And if so, that's going to be exciting, and it would be another one of my most anticipated albums of 2022 for sure. So the next band I want to talk about is Red. Now, to be honest with you guys, if Red announces a new album and they have a new album slated for a 2022 release, I probably wouldn't be as excited about it, if I'm being honest. And I hate to say that as a longtime Red fan, because, well, I'll be honest with you guys, their latest album, Declaration, has not held up very well at all for me. I think the album is only average at best. It's still not as bad as their album Gone, but it's honestly still one of my least favorites. I even prefer Release the Panic over Declaration these days. I know that's blasphemous for some Red fans, because I know that a lot of people don't like Release the Panic, but personally, I don't think that album is as bad as some people make it out to be. But Declaration, that album can get in the bin. But yeah, the album is just so underwhelming, and the album just, it lacks variety, and, you know, I applaud them for the, you know, heaviness that they were trying to go for on the album, but the production is honestly kind of meh, and it's just kind of underwhelming altogether. I mean, Red has just done way better than that. Now, I know the album still might hold up well for some people, but honestly, who still listens to Declaration? I mean, when I go to listen to Red, I'm not going to listen to Declaration. I'd very much rather listen to End of Silence or Innocence and Instinct or something, you know? I mean, Declaration, honestly, is just, it's one of my least favorites from Red. I'm just going to go ahead and say it. I think it's one of their weakest albums. I guess there is a chance that Red could redeem themselves. See what I did there? But yeah, I mean, there is a chance that they could, you know, come back with something better. You know, I actually wouldn't mind if Red tried some experimentation again, like they did on Release the Panic. I personally wouldn't mind another album like Release the Panic. I mean, honestly, I'd rather have that than more of what we got from Declaration, because to be honest with you guys, if the next Red album is anything like Declaration, and if it's just more of the same of what we got from that album, I'm probably not going to be that excited for it, if I'm being honest. I'd probably still check it out of curiosity, for sure, as a longtime Red fan, of course, but it's not anything that I would get super excited about, if I'm being honest. But yeah, once again, I'm willing to give Red a chance, even though the last couple of albums have been some of their weakest material. But Red, they really got to come back with something better. I mean, they really do. I mean, when it comes to this whole alternative metal hard rock scene, I mean, Breaking Benjamin has been putting out better albums than Red has these days. Not including Aurora, of course, because, well, not really a fan of that one these days. But yeah, I mean, once again, I'm willing to give Red another chance. I mean, there is a chance they could come back with something better, and I hope the band knows that. I hope the band knows that fans like me have been underwhelmed with the last few Red albums. So, I mean, we'll have to see what they do. So, the next band I want to talk about is All That Remains. It's been a few years since their last album, Victim of the New Disease, so we are definitely due for a new All That Remains album, for sure. And I do think that their last album, Victim of the New Disease, was their best album in a while. And that especially has me excited for what they're going to do next. If it's more of the same of what we got from Victim of the New Disease, I probably wouldn't complain that much. For me personally, I actually wouldn't mind if All That Remains went back to their roots to some extent. Like, maybe even something like Behind Silence and Solitude, which honestly sounds like melodic death metal, to be honest. I mean, a heavier sound like that, I actually wouldn't mind if All That Remains kind of tried something like that again. But once again, if they did more of what we got from Victim of the New Disease, I couldn't complain. I really couldn't, because that is a very strong album, I think. So All That Remains, there is a possibility we could receive a new album from them in 2022, and if it does happen, it'll be the first album with their new guitar player. So yeah, I'm willing to give this new guitar player a chance, because obviously, if All That Remains think that he's a good fit for the band, you know, I'm sure he's good at what he does. I'm sure of that. So yeah, All That Remains. So the next band I want to talk about is As I Lay Dying, another very consistent band in the metalcore genre. And if they do come out with another album, it'll be the follow-up to their comeback album, Shaped by Fire. And I did hear something about a deluxe edition to Shaped by Fire, about that, you know, happening or whatever, because I know that they've released a song this year that's supposed to be on the deluxe edition on Shaped by Fire. Now, I have heard the song, and I'm honestly just kind of underwhelmed by it. It's not that strong, in my opinion. It's kind of just more of the same. It's kind of samey. But I think most of As I Lay Dying's albums have been very strong. The only one that I'm not real crazy about is their debut, but either way, I'm sure whatever As I Lay Dying has to offer next, I think is going to be really good. So, yeah. I'm not sure if they'll release a new album in 2022. I mean, it is definitely possible, and if not, that may be because of the deluxe edition to Shaped by Fire. But honestly, I would really hate to think that that would be the reason we don't get a new As I Lay Dying album in 2022. That is if they've been working on one, of course. And, you know, what I could see them doing maybe is, you know, possibly releasing a deluxe edition to Shaped by Fire as like a bundle to the next As I Lay Dying album or something, maybe a pre-order bonus. That's something that I can see them doing, maybe, I'm not sure. But either way, I doubt that this band is done. I'm sure they'll eventually release a new album, but we'll have to see. It might come out in 2022, it might not, I'm not sure, but either way, I wouldn't be surprised if we got one in 2022. So the last album I want to talk about for this list is Tool, and there's obviously no guarantee that Tool will release a new album in 2022, considering their album release schedule, of course. They do like to take their good old time when releasing new albums, you know, with their long wait gaps and stuff like that. I actually did hear that the next Tool release will actually be an EP, so if we got a new Tool EP at least in 2022, that would be exciting. It definitely would be, because, hey, more Tool material, you can't complain, right? I can see them maybe releasing an EP in 2022 and maybe their next studio album in like 2026 or something, knowing how they are in their album release schedule. But either way, it is a possibility we will receive something Tool-related in 2022. But at the same time, I would not be the least bit surprised we don't receive anything from Tool in 2022, considering, well, you know how the band is, of course. But yeah, Tool's a solid band, and they've never released a bad album, so whatever they have to offer next, you know is going to be really good. So that's one that I wanted to mention for this list. So that's all for this list video, guys. Those are some rumored 2022 album releases. Once again, these are just rumors. And once again, I'm sure that at least a few of these will happen in 2022. You know, I think some strong possibilities would include Judas Priest, Breaking Benjamin, Overkill, Death Angel, and maybe a few others. But either way, let me know what you guys think of this list. So with that being said, thanks for watching, have a nice day, and take care.